The Queen has undertaken her first royal duties since the death of her husband. Europe Bureau Chief Hugh Whitfield is live in Windsor for us with more. Hugh, it's 5 days now since Prince Philip's death. What was the engagement?
Good evening, Angela. We've heard a lot over the decades, and in particular over the last couple of days, about the Queen's stoic demeanour, and Her Majesty has held firm on an engagement that was in her diary prior to the death of her husband, and Her Majesty held a private audience with one of the senior members of her staff, the Earl Peel. Now, he has been instrumental in formulating these funeral plans for Prince Philip, so we'll have had a very busy couple of days. He is expected to retire soon, hence the private audience with the Queen. Not much, though, else in the Queen's diary, apart from, of course, the funeral this coming weekend, which we do expect, or we are continually told, in fact, by the palace, it will be in line with COVID regulations, hence the fact that there will only be 30 mourners there. And if that is true, that they do stick to those COVID regulations, then everybody inside, apart from people speaking, will be expected to wear a mask. And so that means that we will likely see the Queen in a mask. We've seen her wear a mask before. And she may very well cut a lonely figure inside St George's Chapel, because the rules say that you have to remain socially distant. And that means that the Queen will have to stay at least 2 metres away from anyone else not in her household. Now, the only person who could possibly qualify as being in her household is the Duke's private secretary, who we expect to be the only non-royal person who will be a member of the congregation. So he may be able to sit very close, very near to the Queen, possibly behind, but it will be interesting to see how many other family members are able to get close to the Queen on the day. So like so many other families right across this country, the royal family is grappling with the death of a very dear loved one and the regulations that are enforced by the government because of the ongoing pandemic.
Just awful times, but what a remarkable woman. Thanks so much, Hugh.